First, we'll create a sliding door. In order to have the correct wall thickness used automatically in the Door Settings dialog, pick up the parameters of the load-bearing wall with the Pickup tool or eyedropper. Activate the Door tool and open its Settings dialog. Type Pocket in the search field. Select the pocket door. Set the sill anchor to Story 0 and enter 0.00 for its value. Select the Slide 2 anchor option. Display the Sliding Door Settings panel and select the Door Settings and Opening page. Checkmark the Pocket Frame option. Display the Frame and Leaf page. Uncheck the Centered Leaf option and enter 0.13 for leaf offset. Display the Categories and Properties panel. Select Non-Load-Bearing Element for Structural Function, Interior for Position, and Door for Element Classification. Scroll down to the IFC Properties category and click the Manage IFC Properties button. Click the Apply Predefined Rule button. Select the Omni-Class option for Rule. Type Interior Doors in the search field and click the Search button. Select and apply Interior Doors from the list below. Click OK to return to the Wall Settings dialog. Click OK to apply all changes. Place the first door to the lower left corner of the entrance room. There are two walls intersecting at that point. Click their intersection point. You may press the Tab key to select the appropriate wall. Move the cursor towards the upper right to define the door opening. The door pocket will be placed within the two walls in the insulation skin. The pocket door is not in a convenient position to allow entrance to the interior space. Select it, and then drag it by using the Move, Drag command from the context menu, or you can also use the shortcut Ctrl plus D to activate this option. Let's drag it to the right by 60 centimeters. Type D0.6 into the tracker and press Enter. Deselect the door. Now let's add some more doors to the future restroom area. Open the Door Settings dialog once again. Select the Door object from the Hinged Doors folder. Enter 0.75 for width and 2.10 for height. Select Sill to Story 0. Enter 0.00 for its value. Reveal to Wall Core is also 0.00. Select Side 1 Anchor Point. Display the Hinged Door Settings panel and select the Door Leaf Type page. Select Style 56 for the Door Leaf Type. Click OK to apply all the changes. Place the door so you can enter both rooms. Insert the first door into the horizontal wall as presented on the screen. Insert the second door into the partition wall. We'll place a door into the external wall of the gallery, which is identical to the one at the entrance. Open the gallery floor plan from the pop-up navigator. Choose the ground floor to be traced. Right-click the ground floor in the pop-up navigator and select the Show as Trace Reference option from the context menu. Activate Transparent Fills and Zones from the Trace settings. We want to insert the exact same door as the entrance door below. To get all the settings and parameters, use the Pickup tool on the standard toolbar. Activate the pickup tool and move the cursor over the door on the trace reference until the info tag appears with the basic information of the door. Click once. Notice that the door tool is selected and the info box displays the parameters of the entrance door. Please note, if you have overlapping elements on the floor plan, you can use the tab key to switch between the elements. Set the door anchor to side 1. Place a door at the intersection point of the short vertical wall segment on the right of the horizontal wall. Move the cursor towards the lower right quarter to define the opening direction. Use a guideline if necessary.